हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज शिवम विजय एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू गिविंग अ डेमोंस्ट्रेशन ऑन बेसिक न्यूमेटिक ट्रेनर। इन दिस ट्रेनर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द बेसिक कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ न्यूमेटिक टेक्नोलॉजी, हाउ द न्यूमेटिक साइकिल एंड न्यूमेटिक फोर्स वर्क्स फॉर मूवमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इक्विपमेंट्स। सो व्हाट इज न्यूमेटिक्स गाइस? न्यूमेटिक्स इज बेसिकली जस्ट अ स्टडी ऑफ कंप्रेस्ड एयर, एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ दिस एज अ फ्यूल फॉर creating the mechanical movement or mechanical forces. So where did the pneumatic word comes from? So in the Greek language, pneuma means air or breathe. So the conclusion is about working and study about the air to be compressed and to use it with as a fuel termed as the pneumatics. And system machineries and devices, those who use the compressed air as an input energy source for operation are called as pneumatic components. So there are many requirements of pneumatic controls in the industrial purposes right now in the scenario that it is very useful for increasing the productivity, quality of the products. Also at the same time, the pneumatics are also incorporated to reducing the manpower and to reducing the cost of the final product as well. Because the pneumatic components are less costly and it is very easy to use and feasible and flexible to use with the incorporate industrial equipments. So working and maintenance of the pneumatic components are also very cheaper from other of the equipments through the industry, and it gives the faster response and the faster production in the industrial purpose. Also, when we think about pneumatics and when we think about the operation of pneumatic, we just create an image of working a linear motion of the air supplied energy of any component. But nowadays pneumatics have other important features of like semi rotary and rotary even options for the different type of industries, for pushing, pulling, feeding, clamping, pressing, foaming, or there are a lot of applications for that. Even in the automotive industry we can use the pneumatics, and nowadays pneumatics even are using for the air braking system, for the pneumatic type of braking system, pneumatic horn system for the high capacity of the vehicles, and spray paintings are also involved with the pneumatics. Rather, there are a lot of other type of application with the pneumatic products. That is why it is important to get the knowledge about the pneumatics. Even there is a basic knowledge about pneumatics is essential for everyone who want to go to work with the industrial processes and industrial products. So here we are going to give you some basic component knowledge and basic working of the pneumatic, so you can clear your concept about pneumatic working, how the pneumatic works with this complete pneumatic trainer. So now let us move on to the complete circuit description, component description, how the components are used, how we can work with them, and later on we will also perform some exercises given with the user manual. In the user manual there are complete details about the working of component systems of the complete pneumatic trainer, and you can study the complete literature and the manual given with the complete trainer board. So this is the front view of all the components fitted on the inclined screen of the basic pneumatic trainer. This is the inclined plate of made of complete SS material, powder coated, and this has a stand over here. That stand is flexible. You can easily turn this stand and remove and easily place this machine by after working with your complete setup and experiments. So now I will explain you all the components fitted in them, working of them briefly, and then later on we will see some exercises of this complete system. Also we have also provided some accessories for pneumatic making circuits. There are some PU tubes of different sizes are provided, a cutter for cutting the PU tube as per the required line, some other components like PU fittings, T fittings, stoppers. Also then there is a user manual in which all the details about components, valves and other related pneumatic sections are given, how the pneumatic circuits work. Pneumatic section, pneumatic circuit exercises are also given in the user manual. You can refer them after before working with the complete setup. So the order code is 52105A for this. You can use this order code to find out all the specification and what you can learn from with this complete trainer setup. Now we move on to trainer again, and I will explain you all the components one by one. So we'll start with this double acting cylinder. This is a एयर टाइप डबल एक्टिंग सिलेंडर विथ हैज अबाउट 100 mm ऑफ स्ट्रोक एंड वर्क्स ऑन अप टू 10 बार ऑफ प्रेशर. दिस हैज अ बैक एंड एंड दिस इज द फ्रंट एंड. देयर बोथ द लाइन्स कैन बी कनेक्टेड ऑफ एयर एंड वी कैन प्रोवाइड एयर टू फोर्सिंग दैम टू फॉरवर्ड. एंड इफ यू प्रोवाइड एयर टू द फ्रंट एंड द सिलेंडर ऑपरेशन विल बी इन रिवर्स कंडीशन. देन सिमिलरली we have a single acting cylinder. This is a spring return type single acting cylinder. We can provide forward movement with the air supply, but when we remove the air supply from the back end, the cylinder will automatically back return to the reverse action with the spring connected under it. Then we have roller lever actuators over here. So when the cylinder pushes any of the roller like this with the motion, the air connected to the one end will be passing through when the roller lever switch is pressed from the other end. So that's how we can actuate any of the other operation with the air cycle. Similar operation can be done for forward and reverse action for getting the signals with the air actuation. Then we have flow control valves. These are the inline flow control valves. These are used to control the forward and reverse speed of the movement of our operation of the single acting cylinder, or we can use it in double acting cylinder as well. There is just a valve opening and closing. This works in the front side. Direction is also marked, symbol is also marked. You can study the symbol in the user manual of all the components. So if I turn it on and off, the air supply or air flow will be increased or decreased with this valve provided over here, so that as the air supply or air flow increase or decrease, similarly flow will be increased or decreased because the air flow creates the pressure inside the cylinder, so that the pressure will be generated slowly if the air flow is reduced and pressure will be generated quickly if the air flow is higher. Then this is the pneumatic control or pilot operated 5x2 valve. We are calling it 5x2 because it has the 5 ports. If we leave both the pilot operating valve, this is the input port of this valve. These two are the output port is this valve, and these two are the exhaust port of this valve. So if we say here 3 on the lower side, 2 on the upper side, total 5 ports are presented in this valve, and all of them 2 are used for the operations. So we can say this is the 5x2 valve because 2 are the operation that can be used. So we can connect the both the ports for forward and reverse operation of the valve. For actuating them, we have to provide the air supply from any separate source to them, to this. So this is a pilot operated valve. So when we provide air pressure and supply to this sockets, the valve will be open to the any of the section. There is a circuit diagram over here. We will zoom on that and let us see how the circuit diagram is explained. So this is the graphical representation of the 5x2 operated valve. This is a directional control valve. We just need to control the direction of the valve over here. So here you can see there are 1, 2, 3 ports on the lower side, and the 1 and 2 ports are the upper side, and these are the two signals. So this is divided in two blocks. So when we actuate the right one of the actuator, the signal or the air line, which is the direct inline pressure line, which is at the middle point of this lower side, will directly connected to the B point, or A or B, we can justify it at your own requirement. So pressure line will directly connected to the A line over here, and the return line will be connected with the exhaust here. These are both the exhaust at the valve that we have seen. So this is how the air supply works. This will provide the supply to the any of the direction of the double acting cylinder, and the operation can be performed on the cylinder and the exhaust line, which is connected from the cylinder, whatever the return line is depending upon the operation, will provide the air supply or the air filled inside the cylinder through the return line to the exhaust port. So this is the first operation. On the when we operate the second pilot over here, provide the air supply to the left hand side, the supply from the right hand side should be removed, and when it is operated at this section, the tank line will be connected with the other operated line, whether it is A or B. In the case, if we consider A is at the right one and B is at the left one, so at the first section, if tank or the pressure line is directly connected with the B port, so in the second operation and the second action, the pressure line will be connected to the A port. So that's how the reverse operation will be performed. So this is how graphical symbol is learned and understand in the pneumatic section. Similarly, there are lot of graphical symbols. I will explain you, try to all of them. So this is the symbols of operation of actuation. This is the symbol of pilot operated. There might be other symbols also, whether it is hand lever operated, electrically operated, and there are a lot of different types of operation. Depending on the operation, this symbol will be changed and the working of the cylinder will be defined with these two blocks, or whether these are the three blocks in the depending on the cylinder design. Similarly, there we have a 5x2 similar valve, but in this case this is the spring return valve. We just need to provide the air supply for one operation, and the other operation will be happened with the when the supply is air supply or air pressure is removed from the poppet over here and the pilot over here, and it is returned to the original position with the spring section. So first operation will be happen with the air supply, and when the air is removed, the other operation will be happen automatically with the spring force connected inside the valve. Then this is the hand lever operated 5x2 valve. Working is same with all the three valves that I have explained, but this time we will use this valve in both direction. This is at the middle position, this is the right one, and this is the left one. These three positions are provided with this valve, so both the operation can be performed. When we can turn this lever to the right side, the port, the pressure line will be connected with any of the port, whether it is A or B. We are using this with the connections, and diagram is provided. So when we turn this lever to the right side, the port will be connected with the right one, and when we connect and turn this lever to the left side, the port, the pressure port, will be connected with the A port. So supply will be going through the A port, so you can use this where you want to do perform the operation. Then we moving on, this is the pilot operated push button type of operating valve. This is a 3x2 type of valve. There are two lines inside that and one exhaust line over here. If you are able to see here, you can see when you get the kit properly, when you press the push button over here, the air line will be starts passing through the both lines connected over here, and whether it is in release condition, the air line or pressure line which is going from here will be exhausting continually. So that is how we can use the push button type of operating valve. This is also known as pilot operated push button type of valve. This is the normally closed condition. Similarly, other type of valves for normally open condition are also in the market. Depending upon the operation and depending upon the requirement, there are different type of components and valve are provided in the market. Then we have here the logic controlling valves, in which this is the N type of valve. So the output will be operated when both the lines have the pressure line inside them, then the output line will be occurred. So that is how AND signal works. This is called the AND valve. Similarly, this is the OR valve. Whether it is right or left, if the signal or pressure line is presented, the output will be continuously open. So in case where the machinery required to perform the operation, whether there are any other damages or other process production related cause failure occurs, the OR valve is provided and can be used easily for creating the operation from the one source or from the other source in any condition. Then we have the main input component of this complete pressure line or pneumatic system. This is the AFR unit over here. The air filter and regulator, the full name of this AFR unit is called, in which the air is regulated and filtered with this. So the regulator is used as a valve over here, if we connect the airline at this point, and this is the outlet, the direction is provided on this section over here. So air direction should be completely in the same condition as given and described in the AFR unit. This is the regulator over here. So you can regulate the air pressure to the desired pressure by watching it on the pressure gauge provided on this AFR unit. And then there is a lubricator, and a regulator and filter are also provided. So air can be filtered and lubricated because it is required to lubricate the complete system with some amount of oil. Required amount of oil will be provided, and the moisture content, which are the harmful for any of the air working pneumatic working component. So moisture content will be reduced as much as possible through the filter unit. So that's how the AFR unit works in the complete system. Then we have over here slide valve with the manifold. So this is the slide valve over here after output from the AFR unit, which will be connected to this line. And from here, for working and operation, we can just on this valve, slide this to the right side or the left side. The valve will be starts giving the line over here. Then we have manifold. In the manifold, there are four ways and four supply outlets are provided. These are in the block condition right now, but when we connect any of the line, this will start giving the supply. So this is how designed this. So you can start working, just connect the PU tube fittings on this and you can get the output supply when we turn on the slide valve position. So that was the overall brief description about the all components of this pneumatic trainer. Now I will explain you how to build up the pneumatic circuit, and then we will see the pneumatic circuit in the exercises given in the user manual. Similar exercises pneumatic circuit will be done over here, and then later on we will perform the experiment. You will require a compressor of about the 4 to 5 bar pressure generated through this. So we required about 3 to 5 bar pressure for operating all the components. So now we will see first exercise. So in this first exercise we will see the operation of single acting cylinder. So this is the pneumatic circuit provided over here. So we will do all the circuitry as per this. We required these components given in the table over here. So we required a single acting cylinder for this. 5x2 hand lever operated valve with a spring return is we used this, and then we fill junction box with the slide valve or manifold that we know, and we will use the FRCLM pressure regulator unit with the pressure gauge. So these are the symbols over here. So this is the symbol of AFR unit, air pressure filter unit, and then this is the symbol of slide valve. Slide valve is just works to turn on and off the air supply to the manifold. Then from the manifold we will connect the airline to the port section of P port of the 5x2 hand lever operated spring return valve. Then one end of this hand operated valve will be blocked with the stopper as the cross mark is provided over here. Then we will directly connect one end to the outlet or input of the single acting cylinder, as the single acting cylinder has only one vent to provide the output, and the other output will be another action will be happened with the spring return force. So similar complete action and complete circuit we will be working and built up on the trainer board, and later on we will see the complete exercises working. So firstly we will connect the air supply input, which is coming from the compressor. So this will be connected with the 6 mm of tube over here. Sorry, this is the 8 mm diameter of tube. So this is the input section of the air filter and regulator line. Then we will connect the other end of this AFR unit to the manifold section. So similar size tube is also required. So we'll connect this over here, and this will be connected like this. So this is the input line section. After here you can connect any of the component with the manifold or the junction over here. So this remains constant for all the exercises. So we have done it over here. Now we will do the rest of the connection. So now after connecting the air supply to the AFR unit, right now you can see on the pressure gauge there is no pressure shown. So we will turn on the compressor valve so that pressure will be on. Here you can see and observe the pressure now shown on the pressure gauge. You can adjust the pressure with the regulator by increasing and decreasing it. If you turn this in anticlockwise, the pressure will decrease, and if you turn this in the clockwise, the pressure will be increased. So here we have to just maintain the 3 to 5 bar pressure. So we have adjusted it about 4 bar or 3.5 bar, which is enough to operate all the operations. Now for the further connection, we will just connect the output to any of the manifold, and this will be connected directly to the input port. This is the P line of the hand lever operated valve, and we'll use some other pieces of PU tubes. This will be connected directly to the inlet of single acting cylinder like this. These are the PU fittings. You just need to press it. This is just push it, push fitting also. So if you want to connect any of the line, just push them. This will be connected properly. And if you want to remove them, just press this blue section downwards and the pipe or the tube will be easily come out. Do not apply to pull it, otherwise PU fitting will be damaged. Now we will connect a stopper provided with the complete setup to block the other line input of this. So these are our pneumatic connections that have been done. Now we will operate it. Now for operation, just turn on the slide valve. The operation will be performed according to the line. Here, if the cylinder is at the middle position, there will be no operation. And if you move the cylinder towards the right direction, the pressure line will directly connect it to the A line. If you consider this A and this consider this B, so this will be provide pressure to the backside of the piston, and piston moves forward. So this is the forward action that will happen. And if you move this towards the left one, there is no output from the valve over here. This is the directional control valve. Output is blocked from the stopper, and when the output is blocked from the stopper, and there will be no output on the A line because now pressure port is connected to the stopper line, and which is blocked over here, and there is no outlet line. So inside pressure will be exhausted from this vent over here, and spring return force will be pulls backward the cylinder in the reverse direction. So that is how the forward operation works. You just need to turn this in this way and your operation will be done. So this is our first exercise for this pneumatic component. And now we will going to perform the second exercise. In the second exercise, we will see the operation of double acting cylinder. Instead of using single acting cylinder, we will use double acting cylinder for this. Circuit is same for the complete valve we are using, which is also same. Rest of the circuit will be same for here. In the last circuit, we have blocked this line because there is no output and vent to connect it for the single acting cylinder. But in the double acting cylinder, there are two ends. On both the ends, we will connect the PU tube with the valve, and we will operate the valve in both the direction, and both the operation of forward reverse will be happen in the double acting case. So we'll just need to modify this connection. We will connect this output to the double acting cylinder's output. For this, we just need to turn off the slide valve first. Make sure of always turn off the slide valve before removing the tubes, otherwise air leakage issues will be happen. Now we will remove the output of the cylinder from the single acting side, and we'll connect this to the double acting side, and we'll remove the stopper from the other end as well, and we'll connect the other output of the 5x2 hand lever operated valve to the front end of this double acting cylinder. And now we are ready to operate this again. For operating this, again turn on the slide valve. Pressure is now provided to the line, and here the valve is. So now if we move this lever, right now lever at the middle position, So if we move this lever to the left direction, the pressure port will be connected to the B outlet. This will be considered as A and this will be considered as B. So B outlet will be connected and this will provide pressure to the rear end of the cylinder. As the pressure and the air supply is provided to the rear end, the piston starts moving forward and we can achieve the forward movement. Similar action will be happen when we move this lever to the left direction. At this case, pressure port will be directly connected to the B port and B port will provide supplies to the front end of the cylinder, and the front end generates pressure from the forward end of this piston and the piston starts moving backwards. At the same time, the air filled inside the cylinder from the backside of this piston will start releasing from the port over here, now which is connected, the A port which is connected to the exhaust port over here. So air will be exhausted with this exhaust socket or exhaust port. So we'll move this forward, similar action the forward action provides, and the for reverse action we just need to move this to the other end. So that's how we can achieve forward and reverse and operation of double acting cylinder with 5x2 hand lever operated valve. Now, after completing the experiment, just turn off the slide valve. Now, for the next operation, we will see the impulse pilot operation of single acting cylinder. For this, we required single acting cylinder, 5x2 external pilot operated valve with spring return. Then we also use 3x2 normally closed manual operated valve, the push button valve that we have explained earlier, then junction box and slide valve. Also the FRL unit, the air filter regulator and lubricator unit is also required, and this is the pneumatic circuit. We will build this pneumatic circuit and later see we will how operation will be performed with the pilot operated actuator. So we do connections according to this. For this we will connect the one end of the junction valve with the 5x2 spring return. This one is the spring return pilot operated valve, and output of this will be connected directly to the single acting cylinder, and we need to provide a stopper for stopping the other end. So this is the pneumatic section. Now for actuation, we just need to use this push button operated valve. For this, we will connect the air supply to the one end of this push button valve, and this will provide direct actuation to the pilot operated valve for operating. And this will be connected at this port. So this is the actuation port over here, and if I turn on the slide valve, the air releasing will be starts from the exhaust of this, and when we press this, this will provide air at this vent and this will actuate the pressure line, and the pressure line will be connected with this A port or B port for this, and this will provide pressure inside and forward movement will be happen. So guys, as I am verifying my connection with the pneumatic circuits, I have find a mistake in my circuit. We just connect the input line to this section. So this is the port number 1 of this. This is the port number 2 for giving the output over here for operating the pilot operation. And now our circuit has been completely done. So for this, we just need to turn on the slide valve. And now if we press the push button over here, we can get the forward movement from this cylinder. And as I release this, the air from the supply will be blocked out, and spring return, the spring will pull the cylinder backside again. So this is how we can achieve the operation with the pilot operation over here. For any of the substance in some industries and machinery, if you required operation with any mechanical or manual operation and manual involvement. Just do this type of series and component for using. So now we'll move on to the next exercise, which is the controlling the speed of double acting cylinder using metering inflow control valve. From this, we will control the flow of the metering in or the air supply in, and hence we will control the speed of cylinder in forward or backward movement. So we can add the flow control valve in both, even in the forward or backward, or even in the both lines. So this is the connection. These are the connections which will be same as per the second practical of double acting cylinder. Just we need to add a flow control valve in the input operation from the valve to cylinder. So we'll do this with our PU fittings. For this, we just need to connect all connections as per the double acting cylinder example. Carefully connect all the PU fittings. So we are going to use the flow control valve for this. So we'll add flow control valve with inline of the double acting cylinder. And other action will be without flow controlling. So you can get and see the variation of flow with the speed of the double acting cylinder. So these are the connections of complete system. Now we will turn on the slide valve and then we adjust the flow from the flow control valve and see how the speed of cylinder changes. So here you can see, as we have connected the flow control valve in the backside, so when the reverse action happens, the air filled inside the cylinder will be passing through with the blocked area, which is at a reduced airflow. So this will oppose the forward inlet of the reverse cycle. So air from behind the piston will be moving out very in the slow position, so that this opposes the forward movement and forward force, and that's how we achieve the speed control. So we can decrease the speed with this. So we'll turn on the slide valve and here we see the reverse cycle. This is the forward cycle speed. Now if I turn the valve slightly more for closing it, you will receive that the speed of reverse cycle has been slowed down. If I turn this more close, you can achieve the reverse cycle has a very slow process than earlier. So that's how you can maintain the line pressure. Similarly, for the second line or second operation, the other operation to be controlled, just need to add the flow control valve in the front line, or you can add the flow control valve in both line while working, so that you can control speed at desired changes on both the sections. So these are the basic operational cycles of exercises that are given in the user manual. Now I am just giving you some of the brief examples of other components that are remaining, how to use them. So we'll do some multiple cylinder operation while using the roller actuator. So in this cycle we will do the forward backward movement with the hand lever valve, obviously, of the double acting cylinder, but we will provide the supply to the forward acting cylinder as well, so that when the forward movement happens, this will control the forward action of single acting cylinder as well. For this, we will just using the 5x2 hand lever operated valve for operating the double acting cylinder. So just do the basic connections for the double acting cylinder over here. So these are some extra exercises which are not mentioned in the user manual. I am just explaining it for the video content. So this is the operation of double acting cylinder. Now we will use a single line and connect it with the roller lever actuator to one end, and the other end of this roller lever actuator is connected to the single acting cylinder directly. So what happens when the cylinder movement, forward movement happens, this will operate the roller lever actuator, and the line directly going to the roller lever actuator will pass on and provide it to the single acting cylinder. So that's how multiple actions can be happen with this. So we'll turn on the slide valve, and here you can see as I forward movement happen, similar operation happen with the roller lever actuator, and this will helps to operate the single acting cylinder. Now again, if I remove the air pressure from the roller lever actuator by moving the cylinder backwards, the air supply will be also closed from here, and we can achieve the reverse action for both the cylinders. So if you want to operate this from the reverse cycle, if you want to operate then when the cylinder is reversed, and so at that time the other action of the forward cylinder will be happen, just turn this to the forward side. First we'll turn the slide valve close, remove this connection from here and connect this to the backward sides. So when the reverse movement happens, the single acting cylinder will go forward. Again we will turn on the slide valve. Here at the reverse, single acting will be forward, and at the double acting forward, single acting will be reverse. So that's how multiple operations can be achieved with different types of actuators. So now we will see the working of AND valve. The AND valve requires two different actuating signals to operate one operation. For this we will just use a single operation, so that we have provided single line directly from the manifold, and we will provide the one line from the push button operated valve for operating the single acting cylinder once. For this just connect input here, and output will be provided from the push button over here. So here you can see the one direct line pressure is provided at this point, but this will not operate the cylinder because it requires the other line also when the AND operation is true. As we can see, when both the operations and both the cycles are high, the output will be high. So we'll connect this over here and turn on the slide valve. Right now you can see the line pressure will directly open to the AND valve over here, but this is not operating the single acting cylinder. And now as I press the push button, this will provide the input to the second input of the AND valve, and we will get the forward operation. Here as I provide the both inputs to the AND valve, we have got the forward operation from this. So this is very useful for providing the interlocking, whether there are two signals required to operate one operation for different examples in the industrial processes. So this is very beneficial for safety purpose and other movement also. Similar operation can be done with the OR valve. In this you can use any of the two valves for providing the input to this, and any of the input can be actuated for the cylinder. Now for OR valve operation, we will operate the single acting cylinder, one with the push button operated valve and other with the hand lever operated valve. For this we will use both. So for first one, we will connect the hand lever operated valve with this PU fittings and PU tubings. Output of this valve will be connected to the OR valve over here, and we will stop the other line. And for the push button actuator, we will provide the input to this one, and from the output of push button actuator we will provide this to the second input of OR wall, and from here output will be connected directly to the single acting cylinder. So this is operation. Now here what happens, the cylinder will be operate either if the input from the push button will be high or if the input from the 5x2 hand lever operated will be provided. So in both case, if any of the input is provided, the output will be happen and on. So this is also a very useful and safety features in different type of industrial machinery, whether the safety features in the signal for safety measurement is provided from any of the source, the output will be stopped or actuated. So we'll turn on the slide wall. Here you can see it is operating from this. And if I operate from here, this will also operate the single acting cylinder. Now at this time, if I operating this from the push button, there is no effect from this 5x2 lever wall because the input line is blocked over here. This is a little catch in the OR wall. So when we provide input from any of the output line of this OR wall, the other line will be properly blocked. Now if I operating this from here, the other line will not create any effect on the cylinder operation. So these are the basic operation and all the components that I have covered. The component that is remained is the 5x2 pilot operated valve. This works similar as the 5x2 lever operated valve, and as we provide the power from the actuating signal to this, you can use the 5x2 lever operated valve for providing the actuated operation to this, both the signals for actuation, and connect the double acting cylinder to this valve and you can get the output over here. So that was the complete demonstration of basic hydraulic trainer. I have explained you working with all the components provided here, or if any of the component is remained, the working of the same concept is also explained with other component in the complete system. So as I explained in this video, you can do your all experiments with this, and as I explained in this video, and if you find difficulties while working with this component kit, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. Also you can refer the user manual, all the details and studies and working and explanations are given, so that it will very helpful for you for getting the information and detailed studies about pneumatic components. It is very beneficial for you. If you find this useful, you can share this video to your friends, colleagues and your class fellows for getting the information about basic pneumatic components and basic pneumatic working. Please like the video over here, and also you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of video with detailed practical information with detailed studies are also uploaded, so you can get the information in detail learning about the different type of educational trainers. To press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get the notification about that as well. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.